animation schools and working in hand-drawn animation. Because in hand-drawn animation, you have to understand some of the basic principles before you can even make anything move. But unfortunately, with computer animation, it's very, very easy to make an object move from point A to point B. There's a lot of systems that you can buy off the shelf that you can move things from point A to point B, and so people, you know, don't bother to study the, you know, the whys of moving something from point A to point B. Why do you do it, you know? How do you do it to make it look like it's a bowling ball? How do you do it to make it look like it's a little balloon? How do you do it to make it, you know, seem like marble or you know, give it weight? Or how do you make it to look like it's sad or happy, you know? These are the things that I, you know, that are important to me. In all of our films we do, it's very important to me to have each film be something that cannot be done in traditional animation. I mean, a lot of people ask me with computer animation, so is it going to replace traditional animation? They just assume it is, you know, and it's not. It's ridiculous, because anytime computers come into a new industry, people automatically assume it's there to replace people. Well, traditional animation has got some wonderful qualities to it that you know, computer animation can't possibly get. And so the way I look at it is animation is the art form, and computer is just one of the mediums. You know, there's hand-drawn cell animation, and there's clay animation, sand animation, so on and so on.
Despite working in computer animation, John Lasseter's list of favorite films doesn't include any. However, his appreciation of good animation timing, allied to a funny story, is evident in a film he does include, Cordell Barker's The Cat Came Back.
Tintoy was a very sort of, in many ways, it was a cartoon, but it was realistic in a way. You look at things like this where the shadows are so, you know, accurate and everything, you know, look like painted metal, and we tried to get the baby to look like skin and things like that. Our latest film called Knick Knack was something that was, we wanted to do more of a, like a Chuck Jones, like Warner Brothers cartoon. So I said, you know, okay, it's computer generated, so what? Let's not try to, you know, make people think it's real. It's computer generated, it's, you know, we don't need to worry about all these things that we worried about for, like intersections and proper shadows and so on and so forth. Because I wanted to do a cartoon, something much more cartoony. And so the storyline is very, very much like a Warner Brothers cartoon. It has a lot of like ridiculous gags that build on each other. And it was really fun. It's probably the funnest film that we've created. But I'm also inspired by the work of Frederick Bach, who is a Canadian animator. He did especially Crack and The Man Who Planted Trees. The reason I'm so inspired by his work is the emotion that he gets across in his films.
They were inhabited by charcoal burners. The living was poor, and families huddled together in a climate very harsh both in summer and winter, found their struggle for survival made more bitter by their isolation. There was no relief. Their constant longing to escape became a crazy ambition. Endlessly, the men carted their charcoal to town, then returned home. Even the most stable characters crack under the constant grind. The women, seethed with resentment, there was rivalry in everything. The sale of charcoal and the church people. They were rivals in virtue and rivals in vice. And the battle royal between vice and virtue raged incessantly. And always, there was the wind. The ever-present wind constantly grating on the nerves. There were epidemics of suicide and many cases of madness, nearly always ending in murder.
Frederick Bach will have a retrospective at Bristol and will be in attendance. So too will Alison Devere, a British animator who has a different style and technique, but works in the same painstaking fashion to create highly personal films. Dog is the story of a woman's dream journey through the possibilities within herself. Now, more prosaic, a woman with a different problem. It would be hard to see how using a computer could improve Candy Gard's pithy observations of life.
Right, if I take off £6 for the 90, it's not bad.
Bye!
So, lose £2 a week, an hour of strenuous exercise a day. Oh, I'll be 8.5 stone by the 7th of June, brilliant. Right, better start. No eating, then. What about a fruit diet? Dried fruit? That's fruit. I shouldn't have eaten those raisins.
The Estonian animator Preet Pyan also deals with the realities of life, though his is a harsher vision with a technique to match it.
Где же наши яблоки?
in the United States, you don't get a chance to see, you know, films from Russia or films from Eastern Europe or Japan or you know, short films from all over. You don't get a chance to see those very often. And there are some phenomenal films. Actually, so there's some films, some of these short films have been really sort of instrumental in my development as an animator. And one of those is a film by Raoul Servais, who's a Belgian animator named Harpia.
In Harpia, Raoul Servais has made use of live action, photographed, treated, and re-photographed. Almost live action, its reconstruction frame by frame has made it animation and created a surreal nightmare world stripped of all but the bare essentials. A different kind of nightmare world exists in the Japanese feature Akira. Stage-like live action, it uses a classic cell animation technique to push the viewer into a super real comic strip of violent action. To fans of animation, Akira is quite obviously a Japanese film, one which is easily accessible to a Western audience, used to science fiction movies and the narrative traditions of comic books. Kawamoto's films, on the other hand, draw on completely Japanese techniques of staging. Contrast between films like Akira and Doijoi Temple, Knick-Knack and The Man Who Planted Trees is what makes animation festivals such stimulating and rewarding environments. The latest piece of experimental animation exists alongside an early black and white short, or this, the new film from the team which brought you The Snowman.
The colder weather's coming on now. I thought I felt snow.
It's the International Animation Festival in Bristol, and it's running October 31st through November 5th, right? So go see it.
Such a diversity of viewing can take it out of you, and after rushing from screening to seminar to masterclass, it's good to engage in a little, quiet discussion with colleagues.
Yeah, come here, come here. Yeah, right, let's see it.